我们敬礼传承祖师。
Let's pay homage to the lineage gurus.
了明和尚。
Homage to the venerable monk 了明。
敬礼沙迦真空上。
Homage to Master 沙迦真空。
敬礼十六世大宝华。
Homage to His Holiness the 16th Karmapa.
敬礼图登。
And homage to Master Dubden Darshi.
我们敬礼坛城三宝。
Homage to the three jewels of the altar.
佛、法、身。
Homage to the Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha.
今天护摩的主尊。
Homage to the main deity of Homa today.
独雄。
The soul.Body Mahabala,
大力金刚
the greatly powerful Heruka.
圣母，丹增喀措，
圣母丹增喀措图腾悉地，
各位上师
，All Dharma masters, Dharma educators.Dharma teachers, Dharma instructors, Dharma tutors, directors of temples and centers, all disciples present here and over the internet. Good afternoon, everyone. How do you do?
Niu da gao. Xin zao gan men.愛してる
愛してる
샹에오라미고게게노무쵸스고이인이치바기모지이주미야비브린브린고니치와现在通知大家。
Now I would like to announce.
下礼拜天，三月五号。
For next Sunday, March 5th at 3 p.m.
我们做孔雀明王护摩法会。
We will have Mahamayuri Homa Fire Offering Ceremony.
啊，大家知道这个孔雀明王。
We all know about Mayuri.
他头顶的
Vidyarajni.
头上所戴的冠
The crown that she's wearing is the crown of Vairocana Buddha.
他有释迦牟尼佛
And on her,
直接的
she has the direct.
力量在里面
Power of Sakyamuni Buddha
另外
And
他是阿弥陀佛
She's also Amitabha Buddha's Transformation Body
和三佛在里面
So there are three Buddhas in this deity Vairocana Buddha Sakyamuni Buddha And Amitabha Buddha Three Buddhas, power on Mahamayuri. The power of the three Buddhas
are
on Mahamayuri. Because
没有促销就是报销。
Because if you don't market it, we will lose.With the power of these three Buddhas,
are
on Mahamayuri, so Mahamayuri has great power.
啊，这一尊呢，是在
this deity among all the protectors,
很有 power 的一尊。
It's a very powerful one.
Now, today, do 大力金刚.
Today, we perform Mahabala Homa.
This 大力金刚 is 显现的很有威力。
Mahabala appears great majestic power, manifests great majestic power.
那么他也告诉我
He also told me
这一次的护摩
that the Homa this time
主尊的真实降临
That the real main deity, the original main deity, descended.
Oh, 刚刚我在比手印的时候
when I was performing the mudras, forming the mudras, it was snowing.
很大很大的雪，差不多是
It was heavy.
才停。
Heavy snow for 15 minutes when I was performing the mudra transformations. It snowed heavily for 15 minutes. So that showed that Mahabala came. This mudra, the mudras that I formed were formed by half.Formed by myself and half by Mahabala. So the participants of today's Homa and the primary supplicants and merit holders are truly blessed. This deity is very special.And he especially came today. And he said, He would bestow all participating disciples the marks of the great protector, the great power.
也就是他的
the seals of the marks.
我们修行本身来讲
In spiritual cultivation, when you receive the marks or seals of this great power, means whatever you ask for will be accomplished with great power.
那没有来的，看看没有来的是谁？
And those who are not here, let's look around.
没有来的部分就比较少一点。
Then they have less merit, less fortune. Because he gave the marks or seals of great power. But in the future, they would have great power.
其实你跟大力金刚相应了。
Actually, if you gain spiritual union with Mahabala, then you would receive very great power and authority.
So,
great power and awe and majesty. Prestige or dignity. Mahabala is rarely transmitted in Tibet. There are some, but not many. And today, he becomes the main protector of Truvada school. So that's also.Great affinity, and especially today, he was very pleased especially came here. And he would give miracles for you to see. Let me tell a joke first.
这个小学生的作文题目。
Composition.
喝茶的好处。
Title for elementary school students. The title is The Benefits of Drinking Tea.
非常的多。
And Xiaoming wrote many benefits in drinking tea. My grandpa often go to the Wanhua Tea House in Taipei to drink tea, and he's always happy, smiling, and high spirited. And the teacher noted.Let your grandma sign this composition.
万华茶一碗，很有名。台湾人都知道啊。
The Wanhua Tea House in Taipei is very famous. Everyone knows.
把菜端上餐桌。
The wife served the dish on the dining table and told the husband,
要慢慢的咬，要细细的咬。
Yeah, you should chew finely. And the husband asks why. You should chew it really well. Then you can savor and enjoy my cooking and also help your digestion.At the same time, maybe you can find my hairpin that fell into the pot. The patient asked the doctor, Can I live long enough? And the doctor asked,Do you drink alcohol?
有没有 make up?
Do you make love?
有没有吃美食?
Do you eat good food?
你有没有熬夜的打麻将?
And do you stay late to play mahjong?
或者熬夜的看手机?
Or play with the cell phones late at night? And the patient said, No, none of those. And the doctor asked,What are you going to do to live such a long life?
在一个婚礼的致辞上面
On a wedding, for this wedding speech,Mother of the groom,
小龙的妈妈致辞
give a speech, and she started up to say, I don't like my daughter-in-law.
全场的宾客华南
and all the guests were very quiet.
母亲在讲
and the mother continued.I taught my son ever since he was little how to dress, how to wear the pants.
没想到最后呢
And then, now, the daughter-in-law took them off.
好了，我们进入主题啊。
Now let's get on to the main topic.
台湾的莲花钱安问。
Question from Taiwan by 莲花钱安。
师尊伯安。
Grand Master received you. To the foundation announced that the five directional wealth gods of five parts wealth gods are just like earth gods at the five directions. Because of that, they have no specific forms, no mantra, no syllable. Thus, they state that they are not suitable to be the main deity for tantric homa or dharma ceremonies. And he continued, however, when Grand Master was visiting the various spiritual centers in Taiwan, Grand Master gave a teaching about the five paths, wealth gods, that are specific to Jupiter school. At the center path is the Queen Mother or Golden Mother. In the eastern path is the wealth god Cai Lun. In the southern path is the wealth god Teng Tong. In the western path is the wealth god Wu Ti. And in the northern path is the wealth god Sunlight Youth. Thus, the Jupiter school five paths wealth gods are manifestations of the ancient sublime deities, and they are not just ordinary earth gods. They have appearances, mantras, and of the Golden Mother and six syllables. So my questions are, one, when we use the mantra as the syllable of the deity at the center path Golden Mother, as the mantra and the syllable of the five paths wealth gods, second, with an image mantra and the syllable, we can perform the visualization of merging with the deity, like Golden Mother, so may we have them as our main deities during homas and ceremonies. So their problem, their question, happened to be about announcement by Jupiter school. It said that they're just ordinary earth gods, and yet one set said that the center path is Golden Mother, eastern path Cai Lun, southern path world god Teng Tong, the western path is world god Yigo Wu Ti, and the northern path is the world god Sunlight Youth. So please let's ask Jupiter Foundation to reply. The representative of TBF. Grandmaster, about the five paths wealth gods, we know that in one of Grandmaster's teachings, you said that they are just ordinary earth gods. And Grandmaster also said that the Taoist deities and Hindu deities can be made main deities for homas and ceremonies, except earth gods and dragon gods. So we made the announcement based on Grandmaster's teaching, and we did not know about the teaching in Taiwan. So I kicked the ball to TBF, and TBF kicked the ball back to me.
这个是真的很难讲。你知道密教也有五路财神。This
is difficult to say. Do you know that in Tantric Buddhism, there are also the five colors of gods?
密教也有。 这个红财神, 黄财神,
Jambala, Yellow Jambala, Green Jambala, Black Jambala, and White Jambala.
白财神,
That's riding on a dragon.
这个就是密教的五个财神,
so, these five world deities of Tantric Buddhism can be treated as the main deities for Horus. And also Black Jambala, right?
其实密教的财神都可以做功哦。密教的财神都可以做功。So,
tantric world deities, we can perform homas for the tantric world deities.
这里面哦,
but the five parts world gods and Thais five parts world gods. Anybody knows about the world deity in the southern path called Deng Tong?
Deng Tong.
Anybody? Who is Deng Tong? A very, very rich.
Deng Tong.
If you study history, you would know. What does Deng Tong do? What did Deng Tong do? What did Cai Lun do?
没错，蔡伦就是造纸。
And Cai Lun was a paper manufacturer. Inventor of papers. And Deng Tong invented money or bills.
这个西路财神东地
And the world god in the western part is
难道是那个赵公地
Which deity is this? Is this Zhao Gongming? Of the five Zhao Gongming Is it Zhao Gongming?
Zhao Gongming 是差在红尘榜里面
In the legends of the gods, Feng Shen Bang, he almost was crowned to be a sage or a god by Jiang Ziya. Just barely make the sagehood. And his master told him to stay in the cave, never to go down the mountain during the coronations of the gods and sages, to practice the Huang Ting Jing, Huang Ting Sutra, just to practice the body and the essence, just to stay there. But because his younger sister asked him, and so he went out, and then he could not become a sage. So the Taoist five paths world gods have great origin. And actually, you can also perform homas for them.
五路财神，那才不用做父母。
But if it's a local, five-directional earth gods, then you don't do Homa. So True Buddha Foundation announcement was right. What you said was also right, and what Sujin's grandmaster said was also right. So everybody was right. So if you want to differentiate them, if you want to perform Homa for the tantric five wealth deities, sure. If you want to perform Homa for the Taoist five paths wealth gods, sure, you can. But you cannot perform Homa for the local five directional earth gods.
不要做恶魔。这其实地神其实也很重要。
Earth God is also very important. It supports the local area. In Taiwan, we say
真桃真味托底供，啊，庄头庄尾土地供。
Fields like around the fields or around the area, they are earth gods. Earth gods everywhere, kind of. So it's the closest to us at the earth gods. And I also enshrine them and I always call upon them every night, all the earth gods.And also in our Dharma practice, we call upon them, which we often chant, Om Shri Shri Mahasri Shri 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 Shri
Om Shri 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 Namo Samanto Mokaram Om Doro Doro Devi Swaha Doro Doro Devi Swaha.
This one, Doro Doro Devi Swaha, means the Earth God.
不要小看土地公。
So please don't undermine the earth gods.
你小看他，你走路都会跌倒。
Look down upon them, because otherwise you would fall when you walk.
你走过来，他无形的，他只要伸只一只腿。
So as you're walking, and he's intangible. So if he stick out his leg, then you would trip. So grandmaster.Doesn't dare to offend the earth god. Every night I call upon him. So I respect them all from the top to the bottom. So that's the answer to Lian Hua Qian An from Taiwan. So what you said was right, Jupiter Foundation was right, and what Grandmaster said was also right.
昨天
Yesterday, I said,
很多人还是有点疑问
and many people still have questions.
这里面其实还有很多东西
There are lots of things in this.
因为我觉得其实
Yesterday, the late.Buddhist Vimalakirti told me, you should say it explicitly when the accumulated treasure Bodhisattva asked Sakyamuni Buddha, the question was, what are the reasons that Bodhisattvas can acquire the Pure Land, can attain the Pure Land. What are the reasons? And in this, it also specifies that this is the causal ground. And the causal ground is related to the wisdom of discernment. And the resultant ground is the fundamental wisdom. That's why you should explain it clearly. So now, what Sakyamuni Buddha is saying is why, through spiritual cultivations, Bodhisattvas can have the Pure Land, can acquire the Pure Land. Because it's the causal ground of the Bodhisattva's spiritual cultivation in order to have the Pure Land. So this is talking about the causal ground, but related to the fundamental wisdom, it will not be spoken this way. So what I talked about last night was about the wisdom of discernment. Now you need to understand what is the causal ground and what is the resultant or the fruition ground. So what reasons are there for Bodhisattvas to attain the appearance? So when Bodhisattvas cultivate spiritually at the causal ground, like Sakyamuni Buddha, he had 500 lifetimes where he was Bodhisattvas at the causal ground. What has he done that ultimately he could attain Buddhahood, that he could acquire the Buddha land? So relating to the causal ground, there are many discernments, there are many differentiations, but with respect to the resultant ground, then there is nothing, no acquisition, no acquiring, and no forsaking. Continuing, Sakyamuni Buddha uses analogies, and this is all on the causal ground. Suppose someone wishes to build a palace on a plot of land, he can do so accordingly without much hindrances. If someone wants to build a house, okay, not talking about a palace, okay, just a house, that he can succeed, he can do so because there's a land, so he can build it. And what's the reason? Because you have the land and you want to build a house, then you can apply for a permit and build a house. And then you get the house. The same with the Bodhisattvas. Because there's this cause, there's this land as the cause, so he could acquire or build his Buddha land, a pure land. Continuing, however, should he try to build it in the air, he will not succeed. So, if you want to build a house in the air, in the sky, in the air, like when you see a piece of cloud and you say, I want to build a house on that cloud and for me to live. But there's no ground. How can you build it? You don't have this land as the cause. How can you build the house? So that's the analogy of Sakyamuni Buddha. Such is the case for the Bodhisattvas too. Bodhisattvas acquire the Buddha land to benefit sentient beings, so that these beings can also have attainments. They do not vow to acquire the Buddha land for nothing. So it means that Bodhisattvas cannot acquire pure land without the Saha world. The Saha world is the ground, the land, and those are sentient beings. If you want to be a part for sentient beings to attain Bodhisattva fruition, that's impossible. Sakyamuni Buddha said, at the causal ground, you need to rely on the land to build a house. For Bodhisattvas, if you don't have the causes and conditions to help sentient beings, it's impossible for you to become Bodhisattvas. Now do you understand what I mean? If you don't do anything and you want to become a Bodhisattva, that would be impossible. So even Sakyamuni Buddha, he had to stay in samsara for 500 lifetimes, reincarnation upon reincarnation, until eventually he became a Buddha. Why did he become a Buddha? For what reasons? Because he had accumulated the merit, the land, so that he could acquire the Buddha land. So that's the reason. So the Buddhas come from the world. Bodhisattvas too originated from the world. Sakyamuni Buddha or the Buddha, all the Bodhisattvas never abandon sentient beings. They admit that they are sentient beings and they do all they can to help sentient beings.
把自己的生命跟力量
and to dedicate their lives and their efforts and power for all sentient beings. Only then they can attain the fruition of Bodhisattvahood and to acquire the pure land. So the sentient beings are likened to the land in order to build, so that you can build a house. So what is the cause? What is the reason that a Bodhisattva becomes a Bodhisattva? It's because they help sentient beings. That's why giving generates tremendous merit. Of course, in the true ground, in the true wisdom or fundamental wisdom, there is no merit. But in the causal ground, there is merit. That's why the Buddha often said, the so-called merit is not merit, and because there is no merit, it is merit. There are many such statements in this Vajrasutra. Because the Vajrasutra is about the fundamental wisdom. In the fundamental wisdom, everything is empty, nothing exists. But in the Saha world, on the causal ground, you cannot reject that the Saha world exists, that sentient beings exist. So you generate merit through sentient beings in order to become a Bodhisattva. So suppose someone wishes to build a palace on a plot of land, he can do so accordingly without much hindrances. If you have the land, you can build a house. However, if you have no land and you want to build it in the air, you will not be able to succeed. In the Saha world, is there anyone that can build a house in the air, in the sky? Nobody. Now with advanced technology, people created satellites. In the sky, there's so many man-made satellites orbiting. But they also destroy the order of the universe. And he continues, accumulated treasures, this is how Sakyamuni Buddha spoke. When he answered someone's question, he would say, Master Lian Seng, because the question was asked by Lian Seng, then he would call on the name, accumulated treasures, now that straight mind is the pure land of the Bodhisattvas. A Bodhisattva becomes a Buddha.
这一段话是什么意思?
Without cajoling sentient beings to be reborn in that land. Straight mind, this is the key point. What does it mean?
我这个人跟人家讲说话不太一样。
My Dharma teaching is slightly different. It's different from others. The so-called straight mind
我讲的这个心里面呢、
As I, what I'm saying is that you have no distracting thoughts in your mind. That's straight mind. You don't have running thoughts or random thoughts. That's called straight mind. That's my opinion. But most people would say,They don't get, they don't let go.
不起不舍，不隐不惧，就是执心。
And,
这个就很难解释了。
That's straight mind, that's hard to explain.
不隐不惧。
What is 不隐不惧？
其实它有它的意思在里面。
Actually, they have their meanings too.
能够成为菩萨的净土，是执心。
A bodhisattva can become a bodhisattva's pure land due to the straight mind. But when he becomes a Buddha, he also does not abandon saha world or sentient beings.
但是对众生呢？
So,
应该是不取不舍，不取不舍。
So toward sentient being, he does not hold or forsake. This is hard to explain.
执心，我知道。
Straight mind, I know.
你禅宗有计划。
For a bodhisattva to become a bodhisattva,
你直直的走。
In Zen Buddhism, there is a saying that just walk on the straight line, don't get off the track, then you would become a bodhisattva, then you would acquire the pure land. Just walk straight, what does it mean? So that means you don't have all kinds of thoughts, you can stop.And get off the track.
执心就是你不要走到歪路上面，你走在中间。
And think too much. So straight mind as you walk straight on the path, you don't go off to the left or off to the right. You walk on at the center.
你就耽误你自己本身的行程。
If you get off track, then that would, affect your own journey. So you just walk straight without much thoughts. That's called straight mind. And many more here.
Sakya
Muni Buddha mentioned everything. To become Bodhisattva, first you need to have straight mind. Don't get off the track.Just walk straight. Don't think too much.
身心是菩萨净土。什么是身心呢？
And deep mind is the pure land of the bodhisattvas. What is deep mind?
能够慢慢的从眼耳鼻舌身。
From the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, body, mind, and the root of mind.And then Alaya, and from Alaya, you go to the immaculate consciousness, purity. So it's uncontaminated. That's called deep mind. So from the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, mind, the root of mind, Alaya, immaculate.And when you reach the immaculate body and mind, that's called the deep mind, and that's the pure land of the bodhisattvas. Then you are bodhisattva. You have no more impurities. You're completely pure. How can you become pure? Because of sentient beings. That's why you cannot separate yourself from sentient beings. How can you become pure? Because through the trainings of sentient beings, you become pure. That's why you cannot abandon the Saha world. If Bodhisattvas have no merits whatsoever in the Saha world toward human beings, how can he become a Bodhisattva? He must have generated merit from giving wealth, giving Dharma, giving fearlessness, and lots of givings. And helping sentient beings are all considered giving. So the deep mind is the pure land of the Bodhisattvas. So the Bodhisattva becomes a Buddha when the sentient beings have enough merit. So when Bodhisattvas generate enough merit, then the Bodhisattva would acquire the pure land and have fruition. Can a Bodhisattva regress? Yes. Especially a Bodhisattva that is still at initiate stage of generation bodhicitta. That's why I often mention that Bodhisattva arises step by step until they reach the eighth ground, and when they can confirm the unborn endurance, then that you are not regressing. But if you generate merit and you still think that you generate merit, then you are not a Bodhisattva. Because I or self still exists, so there would begin and last in the Saha world. So for sentient beings, they still have gain and loss, good and bad, right and wrong. But for true Bodhisattva, none of those exist. Amid them, they abide by the precepts. This will all explain later. There are many methods for the Bodhisattva to have attainment. But in the process, you cannot always be thinking about the merit. Oh, this is my merit, and this is the merit I do. Then you are just mundane beings to think like that. A true Bodhisattva will not don't think that this merit is a big deal. They continue to do the merit, to generate the merit, but they don't always be mindful of it. They are not always mindful of them. No such thing.
So,
if you give, that you're just a philanthropist, a good person in the Saha world, although you are a worldly Bodhisattva, you are a worldly Bodhisattva. But if you're not mindful of your merit, but in reality you have done lots of merits, but you're not mindful of it, then you don't think of gain and loss. And you don't accept or reject. And you just do it according to affinity. But the affinity is also non-existent. So don't always be amid the causes and conditions, because the causes and conditions belong to the worldly Dharma and not beyond the worldly Dharma. But true Bodhisattva is beyond worldly Dharma.
这个菩萨成佛的时候啊，就是具足了很多。
When a Bodhisattva becomes a Buddha, he's accumulated lots of merit of sentient beings to attain Bodhisattvahood, and also to transform sentient beings into Bodhisattvas.
这句话的意思。
That's what it means here.
因为你
的 deep mind is the pure land of the Bodhisattvas because you have attained pure mind. In your pure mind, there is none of the so-called good or bad, none of the so-called joy, likes and dislikes.
我曾经有这个心理，我们西雅图那样是开放。
Once I had this thought, Seattle Zen Temple is back open, many people come to eat. I wrote it in my book, and one of them,
beat
the father that raised her and many other things. And yet, she ate at the Seattle Temple 3 meals a day. A person who beat and kicked out the father who raised her.How could she stay around and eat our meals? And then in my meditation, I saw that she was buried alive by that grandfather because the two villages were fighting each other, and her grandfather was the chief, the leader of the village. And then beat the other village and then buried all of them alive. And to retaliate, these people that were buried alive.Reincarnated as the grandchildren of the beater, the person who beat them, who killed them. So they were born to kill and to beat their parents. So that's why.So there's cause and effect, karma.So someone like me, I should not have such a thought. I should welcome this person to eat at the Seattle Temple, but not that person. The person who beat his dad and kicked him out of the house. Is that good? But actually, there's karma in it. Once you understand that,As a Bodhisattva, you cannot have likes and dislikes. You cannot be either way. You can't have either of likes or dislikes. So before, the fact that I read 5 books about ghosts, my realm now has differed from my realm then. I should not despise anybody.I cannot favor someone and despise someone else. As a Bodhisattva, we should not have this accepting or rejecting. We need to treat them all equally because they all have Buddha natures. As long as they can come on track, that would be a good thing. The fact that she could walk such a path, there must be affinity. And in reality, it's all about causes and conditions. So in the future, when I write my books, I should be very conscientious. I should not have any likes or dislikes. I should treat all sentient beings equally.
So,
that's why the Buddha told accumulated treasures. The straight mind is the parent of the Bodhisattvas. The deep mind is also the parent of the Bodhisattvas. And these two together is called bodhicitta, or the mind for enlightenment for the sake of sentient beings. So straight mind and deep mind combined is bodhicitta. So a bodhisattva is the one who generates bodhicitta and always with equality toward the good, the bad, the right, the wrong, the virtuous, the unvirtuous, they're all just acting in the Saha world, the acting of the causes and effects of the karma in the Saha world. To be able to truly attain bodhisattvahood, you have no partial, you're not partial toward the good or the bad, whom you like, dislikes, and right and wrong, etc. So if you want to become a bodhisattva, you need to remember what grandmaster is saying. Only this way, then that would be a true bodhisattva. Bodhicitta is the parent of the bodhisattva. Sakyamuni Buddha said, the bodhicitta is the parent of the bodhisattva. When a bodhisattva becomes a Buddha, sentient beings on the great vehicle will come to this line. Giving and forsake, what is equanimity or forsake? It's that you treat sentient beings equally. This is important. Giving is the parent of bodhisattva. So that can forsake. So they treat sentient beings equally to rise to their pure land. And bodhicitta is straight mind and deep mind combined. Why a bodhisattva becomes a Buddha? Because they have bodhicitta. And why they have bodhicitta? Because they give generosity. They give to sentient beings. If we have famine, we give to people who are starving. And we are impartial. This one, a good person, I can give, but that's a bad person. I don't like to give to that person. Then you're not a bodhisattva. Doesn't matter whether they're good or not, whether they're virtuous or not, you should give to them all. That's called equanimity or impartiality. Impartiality. That a bodhisattva can forsake anything, everything. You can even forsake your life. When Sakyamuni Buddha was on the Bodhisattva path, he has forsaken his life. he fed himself to the hungry tiger to let the tiger eat him. We want to run as fast as we can, climb the tree, but not him. The tiger was very hungry, so he gave up his body to feed the hungry tiger. And when the eagle was hungry, he cut off a piece of his flesh and fed it to the eagle. That's called equanimity or impartiality. You can even forsake your lives. So Sakyamuni Buddha, in his spiritual cultivation during 500 lifetimes, there were many, many examples about his forsaking himself. We shouldn't be like Scrooge, the stingy. Sakyamuni Buddha can forsake anything. So, sentient beings are all equal. If you can give equally to all sentient beings, so in the past when I was young, I was quite indignant. I wrote all these books about the anger of the Vajrayuga, or the fire of the mad Bodhisattvas, and the Hua Sen sort of debates. I want to debate or compete and see who's right, who's wrong, who's higher, who's better. If I find anything wrong with you, then I would want to correct you. But actually, that's wrong. So the wrath of the Vajra, you know, all the articles were very indignant, those were all wrong. And when I wrote about the ghost witch too, that was wrong, because she had her own causes and conditions. And should treat them all equally. Eventually, she would be awakened from her delusion.
So, 不能够有那个厌,
so should not have any resentment or anger or indignation. It doesn't matter what kinds of sentient beings, you need to treat them equally. So, Saint Teresa in Catholicism was truly great. As he spoke the statement that I highly admire, even if I can go to heavens, I will not go there. I'd rather stay with the suffering beings in darkness, spoken by Saint Teresa.
有天堂, 我不去,
even if I can be in heavens, I will not go there. I'd rather stay with the most suffering sentient beings to help and salvage them. So that was spoken by Saint Teresa in Catholicism. The same spirit as Siddhikarpa Bodhisattva in Buddhism. That's a very supreme sage. It's a real saint. So a true Bodhisattva never forsakes the Sahara world.
而有人提倡人间净土。
And nowadays they popularize pure land on the human world, pure land on earth. They wish to turn Saha world into pure land. Yes, it's difficult, but you're still a worldly bodhisattva. Just like Saint Teresa.She's a bodhisattva on earth, in the world. She wished to stay in the darkest and the most suffering place to help them. That's why she could become a saint. That's how Saint Teresa was.So the Dharma teaching of Sakyamuni Buddha, Bodhicitta is the parent of the Bodhisattvas. When a Bodhisattva becomes a Buddha, sentient beings on the great vehicle will come to this land. He delivers all sentient beings and he gives to all sentient beings. Giving is the parent of the Bodhisattvas. When a Bodhisattva becomes a Buddha, all sentient beings who have forsaken can come to this land. Who can forsake will come to this land. That's what it means here. An old couple is fighting and always nagging all your life, and I've thought about what I will write on your tombstone. What will you write?Continual nagging. The continual nagging is finally shut off. And the wife said, "You will die first, and I've thought about what I will write on your tombstone." What would you say? Always soft and weak all his life, and only now he's hardened.
Om Mani Padme Hum.
Om Mani Padme Hum.